Here we go.
I am Max Payne. My wife and daughter were murdered. It had something to do with the designer drug V. I transferred from the NYPD to the DEA. Went undercover to find their killers. I got too close. I was framed for murder. With nothing to lose, I went after the mafia during the worst winter storm in a century. My first stop was Vinny Gagnetti, a lowlife in the habit of taking his frustrations out on underage call girls. I left him bleeding in an alley after I'd gotten what I wanted out of him. I met Mona Sachs in a gothic nightclub, Ragnarok. She was a hired killer. We were after the same man, her sister's sadistic husband. I was drawn to her for all the wrong reasons. I made a deal with Vladimir Lem. The Russian was a smooth operator. He helped me get to the mob boss I was after, but I was in over my head. The government was involved. A mystery man called Alfred Woden told me the name of my real enemy, Nicole Horn. Woden and Horn were both members of a secret society, the Inner Circle. She was behind V, behind everything. While working for the DA, my wife had accidentally seen papers that incriminated Horn. Woden promised to take care of the charges against me if I took Horn out. Deputy Chief Jim Bravora of the NYPD was trailing me by the empty shell casings that I left behind. Gunshots made me deaf to the sirens, but they couldn't drown the sobs of my dead wife. Mona sided with me against Horn. She took a bullet for that. Her body disappeared behind closing elevator doors. I killed Horn. I gave myself up to the police. I had enough evidence against Woden to know that he'd keep his promise. I lied to myself that it was over. I was still alive. My loved ones were still dead. It wasn't over.
A damsel in distress.
They were all dead. Love kills. Did I love her? Was there a choice? The past is a gaping hole. You try to run from it. The more you run, the deeper, more terrible it grows behind you. Its edges yawning at your heels. Your only chance is to turn around and face it.
We are at the scene. Repeat, we are at the scene.
But it's like looking down into the grave of your love.
Check the area. Hold your fire.
Or kissing the mouth of a gun, a bullet trembling in its dark nest, ready to blow your head off.
We're losing him.
Multiple gunshot wounds. Pupils blown. Head trauma. God only knows what else.
He's in shock. Start 2 large-bore IVs. Get him to ICU.
He's not responding. This guy is a train wreck. We're losing him.
When I woke up in the hospital earlier tonight, I thought it couldn't get any worse. I opened my eyes, and everything slid into focus. She was dead. I was hurt. My crime, what I had done, was like a hungry pit behind me. I had to run, get as far away from it as possible. The world was out of joint. I was hallucinating. I had to get away.
Max, the route's clear.
Allow me to present Max Payne.
Come on, officer.
We're here.
Deal with you, my friend.
Payne. We need to get out of there. We need to leave now. Sorry.
Run! Run!
Max, what's going on?
Max, about what happened?
Anyone there?
I would fuck her.
Max Payne! Drop your weapons! NYPD, freeze!
What are you so afraid of? What do you want from...
A blind spot in my head. A bullet-shaped hole where the answer should be. Call it denial. I wanted to dig inside my skull and scrape out the pain.
I'll deal with Payne. He's as good as dead.
Freeze, NYPD!
Found him!
Mira, far, far, but that.
You're not going anywhere. What happened out there? You did it. Eternal Affairs is breathing down my neck. Did you do it? You killed her.
No, I can't.
Bullshit.
What the?
You'll end up running in circles until you fall back down to the same hole you were trying to escape from, only the hole's grown deeper. Tried to run from it, edit it out. Winterson was dead. I was a murderer. A false start. The hospital bed wasn't the beginning. It was past the point of no return. A fatal choice already made. And it would get worse before the end. The past is a puzzle, like a broken mirror. As you piece it together and cut yourself, your image keeps shifting, and you change with it. It could destroy you, drive you mad. It could set you free.
You, inside, drop your weapons and come out with your hands above your head.
You'll see the choices you didn't know you'd made, like staying at work late to chat with a friend, instead of hurrying home to your family.
Fan out, people! Circle around! Cover all the exits!
Kissing her, I think of the cold laws of cause and effect.
Where are those extra units? Call the Central! We need every available unit here now!
I am afraid, but I start again from the beginning. Trace my own steps to the scene of the crime. I had wanted to be punished for what I had done, but Alfred Woden had kept his word. With his influence, ridiculously, I had emerged from my history of violence unscathed, a hero. I didn't thank him. I couldn't stomach it. I left the DEA. I went back to where I had started out, back to the job, the NYPD.
Reported shots fired in the warehouse there, acknowledged.
It's mine. I'm on it.
10-4.
It wasn't a call for a homicide detective, but I knew the address. The warehouse belonged to Vladimir Lem. He was connected to organized crime. We went back a while, like brothers caught on opposite sides in a civil war. His words. I need backup. Unknown number of armed perps inside. Possible hostage situation.
10-4, backup is on its way.
I'm going in. With no way to deal with the past, I kept my eyes on the road, off the rearview mirror and the roadkill behind me. I chased lesser mysteries, other people's crimes.
NYPD!
Whoa, easy, officer, easy. Just cleaning the place. Come on, officer, it's all legit. I work for the squeaky cleaning company.
You didn't hear anything suspicious just now?
No. Oh, wait! You mean the gun workshop upstairs?
Take me there. Move.
Sure, officer. If that's what you want.
You know, officer, you cops got it easy. All you have to do is go to the crime scene and look around a bit. We're the ones who have to clean up that mess, brains and guts and shit.
Detective.
DT, huh? You know what I mean. You get the credit, what do we get?
Right.
Oh yeah, you know what I'm saying.
After you, Detective. Oh, Detective, I've got something for
you. Shoot! Shoot!
The perps were masquerading as cleaners.
Than to bleed on the floor.
That's the ticket. We should find a way to kill him without spilling any blood. You know, gas him or poison or something.
Thank you.
waiting at the van. The hardware's been bad. As soon as the guys get Jackie Brown in there taken care of, we're done.
Okay. I'll round up the crew, make sure the cleanup's done. Bodies, blood, prints, air, mags, empty brass. When we're out of here, there won't be a shred of evidence for the cops to find. Just a ghost.
Hey!
The room looked like a gun storage, but it had been cleaned out. The answering machine had a message on it.
You've reached Annie Finn. I'm not here right now because I'm building some nasty things that kill. So leave a message after the beep.
You have one new message.
Sweet Annie. Vlad here to be a gun in your gentle care. Ah, man can dream. Sorry I couldn't be there as promised. Something's come up. Nothing to worry about, but keep an eye out for trespassers. If anything happened to you, anything comes up, just whistle, and I'll be there.
You have no new messages.
I told you to sit down.
Enough chit-chat. Finish her.
Wait! The mob guys attacked us! I have no beef with you guys! You took them out! Listen, I work for Vladimir!
Honey, you work for no one.
What do you want? We can...
NYPD, drop him!
Finish her!
Oh, God, no!
Like all the bad things in my life, it started with the death of a woman. I couldn't save her.
After him! Don't let him get away! Damn!
How long can it take? They're not supposed to cuddle with her afterwards.
Let's wrap this up. Coffin wants us to move.
What the?
Damn!
Come on. Finally.
Hey!
Mona?
Max, we gotta stop meeting like this.
Mona!
If you think nothing can get to you, you're lying to yourself. At best, you're temporarily dead. A lightning bolt can reanimate you without a warning. My backup had arrived, but the cleaners were slipping away, making a run for it.
Right?
I'm okay, damn it.
Hey, we're working together on this.
You got sloppy, Payne. You screwed up. It's unacceptable that she's dead. You can do better.
I played it as business as usual. But everything had changed the moment those elevator doors opened to reveal Mona. Annie Finn was a licensed gunsmith, licensed dealer in firearms.
Right. The property owned by Vladimir Lem. Three groups. One, DOAs who had connections to Russian OC.
Identified as Finn's employees.
Two, the Mafia. And three, the clowns wearing the cleaning company jumpsuits.
They mentioned a name, Kaufman.
This one's evil. It has only started. I don't like it. I don't like it a bit. It's yours, Payne. It makes no sense. For you, Winterson. Homicide. Sebastian Gate. It's gonna be all over the news.
The senator?
Winterson was the ideal. What the job was all about. Someone to look up to. Bravura knew it, too.
We got lucky. There's an eyewitness.
She hovered over my shoulder, whispering warnings. I didn't want to listen. Mona was the suspect in Winterson's case. I didn't tell them I had seen her. I wanted to stall. Maybe it was because she was alive when everyone else kept dying on me. Survivor's guilt washed away.
Detective Winnison's phone.
Give me that.
Your boyfriend.
The computer search on the squeaky cleaning company in Kaufman had come up empty. I needed to talk to Vlad, get his version, be the bearer of bad news on Annie Finn. Vlad had bought the old Ragnarok nightclub. He was renovating it into a trendy restaurant, Vodka. Mona's appearance had triggered a dislocation, schizophrenia. I felt elation, but with it, fear that all the past evils had come along for the ride.
Max! 911! Bad guys with big guns! They've got me pinned down at the entrance hall! Could use some help! Could use it now!
I had to find another way to reach Vlad. No time to call backup. My case had a life of its own. I got in through the back door. Memories of my previous visit here lurked in the shadows. A musty smell under the coat of new paint.
Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to present Max Payne, New York's finest, with the biggest mobster body count ever. Dearest guests, prepare to die. Max, I'd love to come and welcome you, but I'm busy dodging bullets and hiding under a desk at the moment.
Stop it!
Too many!
Then he's down. All clear here. Hey, they want war? We'll kill him. Right, Fats?
Hey! Hey!
Someone was talking on the other line. Vlad, shut up and stay alive. I'm coming.
Max, you heard him. He's coming for you. Max, these wise guys are really lousy shots. You should have no trouble taking them.
Adventures of Captain Baseball Bat Boy, episode 165. Captain Baseball Bat Boy's girlfriend.
Yeah, she's not my girlfriend.
Captain Baseball Bat Boy's arch nemesis.
That's more like it.
Bicycle Helmet Girl.
Jesus Christ, apocalypse now. Got some heavy shit here.
Tone it down. Just take everything. Leave them nuts.
Winterson would have found a way to do this nice, neat, and clean. Logic told me backup should be on its way. Someone must have heard the gunfire. Logic was such a liar.
Teeth. The whole set for a tooth. The only way to do it. Hey, Chip, one of ours, we go dental on him.
Hey, what can you do? Vinny's the boss. Half of the time, he's too busy playing with his toys.
Gun business is our business. Ours. I don't care who says otherwise. We're in the gun business.
Right. What can you do?
Forever. Thank you.
moment there. But my gun doesn't have unlimited ammo. If you can, hurry.
Damn! Die! Damn! Die!
Vlad wouldn't be able to hold on much longer, if it wasn't too late already.
It's Payne!
Thank you. even trying!
Hang on, Vlad.
Max!
I'm coming.
Fuck! What are you waiting for? Circle around and kill him! Kill the cop!
The way your hands are shaking, you couldn't hit a truck!
Shut up! You're gonna die, Duncan!
Cogniti, a criminal mastermind?
He is wiping out everyone he sees as competition on the black market gun trade. The mafia underboss has made a deal with someone powerful.
What was it you did for a living again?
Scout's honor, detective. I have mended my ways, evolved to a higher level. Vodka will be the best restaurant in the city. I'll be rich and famous. Annie was a princess. They killed her for no reason.
You hurt your hand just now?
A hot date yesterday. Can I tempt you?
Let's pretend I'm on duty. Home, sweet home. Something in the night felt like a door had been opened, an echo of the past, an old monster snapping its eyes open in the depths of my brain. Closing your eyes forces you to look at the darkness inside.
And now, address unknown.
I hadn't slept in a long time. When I did, my dreams were nightmares.
I was trapped in a nightmare. My evil double had taken my girlfriend.
In a nightmare, every choice you make is a wrong one.
Following him, I had somehow slipped into a twisted alternate reality. Noir York City.
I would wake up at night, afraid that day was a dream I'd forget.
My double was John Mira. He was the devil incarnate. A fallen angel.
The first of fallen angels?
He was a serial killer. He had framed me for his murders. I was hiding in a cheap motel. One night, I woke to a knock at my door. Someone slipped a note under the door. It was a clue. I descended into a mystery, desperate to...